Okay, hi everyone. So welcome back to our today's class, and I hope you guys are in a good condition. So, as previously, I already teach you guys on how to answer the essay for section C, right? So as for today, what are we going to learn? Okay, so don't worry, come have a look on what are we going to focus for today's class, okay? So for your information, as for today, I am going to teach you guys on how to answer the section B question, okay? So for your information, as for the section B question, there are two questions, okay? It will be section B1 and also section B2, okay? As for the section B1, it carries 3 marks, okay? And for section B2, it carries 12 marks. So the total marks for section B will be 15 marks, okay? 15 markah untuk bahagian B. Okay, next one. As for the question, okay? Untuk soalan bahagian B, for section B1, usually they will ask you to list 3 points from the passage provided. Okay, for this section B, they will give you a passage. Okay, they will give you a picture with the information. So you have to read the information provided before you answer the question. Okay, untuk section B ni, selalunya dia bagi awak petikan ataupun gambar dengan maklumat. So awak kena baca dulu maklumat yang dia bagi tu sebelum awak jawab soalan-soalan dia. Okay, so as for the section B2, you have to write an essay between 50 to 80 words. Okay, untuk essay section B, awak kena tulis karangan di antara 50 hingga 80 patah perkataan. Okay, it's only between 50 to 80. Okay, it's a short and compact essay. Okay, karangan awak kena pendek tapi padat dengan isi. So don't worry guys, later I am going to share with you the tips that is very useful for you to help you to write the essay for the section B2. Okay, so that's all for the introduction for section B question. Okay, next we are going to look at the example for the section B1 question. Okay, for section B1, okay, list the answer. Okay, this is the example of the question that usually they will give it to you. So first of all, when you receive the paper, of course you have to read the instruction. Awak kena baca dulu arahan yang diberi. So come have a look. They says here, study the information about the two fruits below. Okay, answer the question that follow in the space provided. Okay, as you can see over here, there are two pictures. Okay, one is cempedak and another one is jackfruit. Okay, what is jackfruit? Okay, jackfruit ni ialah nangka. Okay, so dekat sini awak kena tengok cempedak dengan nangka. Okay, so first of all, come let's read for the cempedak description. Okay, size smaller than the jackfruit. Okay, seeds about 50 to 100 depending on the size of the fruit. Seasonal. Okay, next, thick prickly skin. Okay, thick prickly skin ni maksud dia punya kulit tu tebal dengan berduri. Okay, untuk kulit cempedak ni dia tak adalah berduri sangat, dia macam ada bergerutu sikit kan. So the prickly skin ni maksud dia kulit dia macam bergerutu and ada duri sikit. Okay, that is mean for prickly skin. Okay, next, can be eaten fresh or cooked. And then last one, fruit, sweet with strong aroma. Okay, aroma ni maksud dia bau lah. Okay, sama je. Okay, next. For the jackfruit description. Size. Largest fruit grown on the tree. Seeds. Hundreds depending on the size of the fruit. Thick prickly skin. Non-seasonal. Fruit. Sweet with strong smell. Can be eaten fresh or cooked. Okay. That's all. So, you already read the description for each of the pictures. So, now, what is the answer, the question? So, the question state, list three similarities between the two fruits. Okay, dia kata, senaraikan tiga persamaan. Okay, antara kedua buah tersebut. So, just now we already read, right? So, can you detect over here? Which are the similarities between these two fruits? Okay. Benda yang sama antara kedua buah-buahan ini. First kali, cuba awak cari words ataupun sentence yang sama. Okay, first. Cuba tengok yang pertama. Size, smaller than the jackfruit. Size, largest fruit grown on the tree. Okay, it's different. So, out. Tak boleh. Second one, seeds. About 50 to 100. Seeds, hundreds depending on the size. Okay, not same. So, cannot be used. Seasonal. Non-seasonal. Okay, tak sama. Next, thick prickly skin. Thick prickly skin. Okay, yes. So, we got one point over here. Can be eaten fresh or cook, okay, can be eaten fresh or cook. And then next one, here also, can be eaten fresh or cook, okay, same. So, that is the second point. And then for the third point, fruit sweet with strong aroma. Fruit sweet with strong smell. So, we already got the 3 points. So, the answer will be number one, thick prickly skin. Number two, can be eaten fresh or cooked. And then number three, fruit sweet with strong aroma. So the total mark here that you will get 3 marks. Okay, it's very easy only. Usually for the section B1, they will just give you the easiest one. Okay, diorang akan bagi awak soalan yang senang. So awak kena jawab berdasarkan petikan sahaja. Okay. Got it? Okay, next one. This one, that's all for the section B1. So, next, we are going to look at the section B2. So, for section B2, for today, I am going to focus for you guys for the essay for email or message, okay? And then next one, okay, for your information, of course, you have to write 3 paragraph for this section. Okay, awak kena tulis 3 perenggan untuk section B. Okay, same as for the section C also. Okay, and then next one, I'm going to share with you with some tips that is very useful. Okay, yang sangat berguna yang awak boleh guna untuk jawab section B2 ni. Okay. And then for the last one, I'm going to show you the sample question on how you want to apply the tips. Okay, so come, let's have a look. Okay, first tips. For the first paragraph, okay, as you can see over here, hafal, okay. What you need to do is you need to memorize these things, okay. What is it? Apa yang awak kena hafal tu? Okay. Ayat yang awak kena hafal, okay, for the first paragraph is, how are you? I hope you are in the pink. I want to tell you about, okay, for the yellow color sentence, okay, you need to memorize, okay. So, this one, the sentence you can use for all of the email and message essay, okay? So you have to memorize this, okay? You have to memorize this to help you to write a better essay for section 2, okay? So maksud dia dekat sini, awak apa khabar? Okay, saya harap awak dalam sehat sejahtera. Okay, in the pink tu bukannya maksud dalam warna pink. Okay, in the pink ni membawa maksud dalam keadaan yang sehat. So you use the proverbs. Okay, awak guna proverbs untuk bertanya khabar. So you get the extra points over here. And then saya nak bagi tahu awak tentang, okay, in the bracket I put over here is topic for the essay. So over here you need to put the topic. Okay, awak kena letak topik berdasarkan karangan yang dia bagilah, berdasarkan teks yang dia bagi. So this one you have to search in the question. Okay, that one is for the first paragraph. Okay, remember, memorize this sentence. Okay, next, later I'm going to show you how you want to use this sentence in the essay. Okay, next, for the second one, for the second paragraph, what that you need to memorize is hafal ayat point. Okay, you have to memorize the point for the second paragraph. So what is it? This is the sentence. Okay, first, P1 conjunction E1 full stop. Next, P2 conjunction E2 full stop. Finally, P3 conjunction E3 full stop. Okay. Okay, you must be wondering what is P1, what is E1. Okay, so don't worry. P stand for point, and then E stand for elaboration. So for example, first, so over here you need to put the first point. Okay, you need to put the first points, okay, with the conjunction. So conjunction ni kata hubung. Okay, you already learn in grammar part. Okay, so you must memorize the conjunction, the few conjunction that you can use to write an essay. Okay, and then after the conjunction, you have to put the E1, the elaboration one. Okay, huraian untuk point yang pertama. Okay, that one is for the first sentence. Okay, for the second sentence, next, point 2, conjunction, and then elaboration 2. Finally, point 3, conjunction and elaboration 3. Okay, this one you have to memorize. Okay, so for the P1 conjunction, for the P conjunction and E, you just have to add on based on the question. Okay, berdasarkan soalan yang dia bagi dan berdasarkan maklumat yang dia bagi. Okay, awak cuma perlu masukkan sahaja maklumat dan awak kena huraikan. Okay, E stand for elaboration. You need to elaborate your point to get the marks. Okay, so this one also you have to memorize. Okay, awak kena hafal yang ni. All this one you have to memorize. Okay, it's very important. Okay, next, of course, I'm going to show you how you want to use this. Okay, don't worry. I am going to show you how you want to to apply this. Okay, so that one is for the second paragraph. Okay, next, we move for the third paragraph. Okay, untuk perenggan yang ketiga, you need to hafal what? Memorize what? Okay, you have to memorize this sentence. Okay, that's all from me. See you soon. Goodbye. Okay, itu sahaja daripada saya. Jumpa lagi. Bye. Okay, so this sentence you can use for all email and all message. Okay, awak boleh guna ayat ni untuk semua email ataupun semua message. Okay, so that's why I ask you guys to memorize this. It is very universal. Okay, all these sentences that I give to you is very universal. You can use it in all of the essay type to help you to write a better one. Okay, so okay, so that one is for the third paragraph, untuk perenggan yang ketiga. Okay, the one that you have to memorize is this sentence. Okay, awak kena hafal ayat ni. Okay, okay, sure. So next, we are going to move for the sample question. Okay, ini contoh ayat dia, contoh soalan. Okay, the sample of the question. Okay, over here you need to read. So over here it state that famous Malaysian food. Okay, makanan Malaysia yang terkenal. So first one, nasi lemak. The point is delicious rice, spicy sambal, fried anchovies. Okay, second one, chicken rice. Okay, fluffy rice, spicy chili and ginger sauce, fried grills or steamed chickens. Okay, third one, variety of kuih, some sweet, spicy and savory, traditional preparation, colorful. Okay, next, fourth one, char kway teow, stir-fried broad rice noodles, spicy cookies and seafood. Okay, the fifth, the last one, fried rice, traditional Malay Chinese fried rice, popular, served with fried eggs and soy sauce. Okay, so after you read the passage, okay, the passage provided, of course next you have to read the question. Okay, so this is the question. The question state that your friend would like to know a little bit about Malaysian cuisines. Okay, cuisines ni maksud dia makanan, food, same meaning. Okay, he would like to taste some when he visits Malaysia in October. Write an email for him telling him about at least 3 foods that he might enjoy during his visit. Write your answer between 50 to 80 words. Okay. Dia kata dekat sini, kawan awak nak tahu, okay, serba sedikit tentang makanan di Malaysia. Okay, dia nak rasa sedikit apabila dia datang melawat Malaysia pada bulan Oktober. So, dekat sini awak kena tulis email untuk dia untuk memberitahu dia sekurang-kurangnya 3 makanan yang dia boleh makan bila dia datang melawat Malaysia. So, awak kena tulis jawapan awak di antara 50 hingga 80 patah perkataan. Okay, sorry teacher baru perasan. Okay, over here it can be him or her. Okay, boleh jadi lelaki atau perempuan. Okay, based on the question. Okay, I forgot to put the her over here. So, I'm so sorry. Okay, so never mind. So, next I'm going to show you how you want to apply the tips in the essay writing. Okay, so over here you need to know the format for email. Awak kena tahu format macam mana nak tulis karangan untuk email. Okay, so come, let's have a look for the next one. Okay, this one, the passage for the first one just now. So this is the example of the essay, the example of the answer on how you want to write. Okay, untuk for the email format, okay, this one, they usually will provide you the format for this one, okay? They will give you the format. You just have to fill in the email only. So, from who? Okay, so you are the one who write the email. So, of course, over here, you need to write your own name, okay? Awak kena tulis nama awak sendiri and then at gmail.com, okay? This Gmail can be Yahoo or whatever, as long as it is email. Okay, email address. And then two, awak nak tulis kepada kawan awak. Okay, so you just write your friend's name over here and then add email address. Okay, and then subject. Okay, the subject, usually the paper will give it to you already. Okay, so they put here best Malaysian food. Okay, so if it is not written for you, you have to search the subject in the question. Okay, awak kena cari tajuk dia tu apa dalam soalan yang dia bagi. Okay, boleh ya? Okay, so how you want to write an email over here? First of all, you have to write Dear Ariana. Okay, because over here I wrote Ariana. Okay, so saya nak tulis email ni kepada Ariana. So Dear Ariana, comma, the first paragraph, I asked you guys to memorize just now, right? So now apply the sentence that I asked you to memorize. Okay, how are you? I hope you are in the pink. I want to tell you about, okay, the best Malaysian food. Okay, this one is the topic from the question. Okay, this one, the best Malaysian food. So you just add on from the topic. Okay, to complete the sentence that I ask you to memorize. Okay, okay, that one is for the first paragraph. Done, complete. For the second paragraph, okay, first, the red color it stand for point one, right? So the point one will be, you can try nasi lemak, which conjunction, I put the conjunction which over here. And then the elaboration one, which is served with spicy sambal. Okay, first food that I choose is nasi lemak. Okay, so why your friend need to taste the nasi lemak? It is because, okay, you can choose either one from these 3 points, okay? So I choose it served with spicy sambal. Full stop. Next, point two. You can taste the chicken rice conjunction because elaboration two. You can choose between fried, grills or steamed chickens. Okay, the second food that I choose is chicken rice. Okay, why? Because you can choose between fried, grills or steamed chicken. Okay, pilih salah satu point ni and then masukkan dalam huraian dia. Okay, for the second sentence. Okay, so for the second one is done. For the third one, finally, point three, you can try our fried rice conjunction as they serve it with fried eggs and soy sauce. Okay, the elaboration three, fried rice. Okay, the third menu that I choose is fried rice, nasi goreng. Why? Because it's served with fried eggs and soy sauce. So I put the elaboration over here. Full stop. Done for the second paragraph. Okay, third paragraph. That's all from me. See you soon. Goodbye. Okay, the third sentence for the third paragraph, I ask you guys to memorize. So just write it back. Okay, tulis semula ayat yang teacher suruh awak hafal tadi tu untuk completekan essay awak untuk perenggan yang ketiga. Okay, and then when writing an email, you have to put over here on your left hand side, di sebelah kiri. Okay, regards Minah. Okay, you are the one who write the email, so you have to write your name over here. Okay, awak kena tulis nama awak dekat sini. Then I prefer you guys to use the word regards. Okay, untuk penutup dia, teacher nak awak guna perkataan regards ni because the regards is very universal. Okay, you can use this to write for everyone. Tak kira is it, tak kira benda tu formal ataupun informal, to play safe, okay, you can use regards, okay, as the closure. Okay, and then all of this paragraph, it is total 76 words. Okay, so as you can see over here, I just apply the thing that I ask you to memorize. Okay, when you memorize the sentence, you just have to add on your point and your elaboration. It is very easy for you to apply these tips and it can help you to get more marks. Okay, definitely you can score 15 over 15 if you really apply all the tips that I show it to you. Okay, I really want to help you guys to gain more marks. Okay, so just follow the tips, memorize the sentence. Okay, and then I am pretty sure you can write well for the section B essay. Okay, just memorize the sentence. Okay, paragraph by paragraph. Okay, so over here the total will be 3 paragraphs. Okay, so this is the example of the answer on how you want to apply the tips that I show it to you guys just now. Okay, so as for the conclusion, 3 main things that you have to memorize. For the first paragraph, you have to memorize this. Okay, this sentence in the yellow color. Okay, and then this one, you just have to add on yourself. You have to search for the topic in the essay. And then second paragraph, you have to memorize the point. Okay, the sentence will be first point 1 conjunction E1, next point 2 conjunction E2, finally point 3 conjunction E3. Okay, you have to remember P stand for point and then E stand for elaboration. Whenever you put point, you have to elaborate your point. Okay, awak kena huraikan point awak tu so that orang akan faham bila dia orang baca awak punya essay. Okay, and then third one, you just have to memorize the third sentence for the third paragraph. Okay, that's all from me. See you soon. Goodbye. Okay, so those are the tips that is very useful for you to use to help you to write for the section B essay. Okay, so I hope you guys will apply these tips, okay, in your writing for section B. Okay, just memorize all the things that I gave it to you and I am pretty sure you can write very good for the essay. Okay, trust me. So just apply these tips. Okay, and then try to do the exercise that I provide to you. Okay, remember, apply this tip. Okay, and then don't forget to write the total words, okay, of the essay. And I hope you guys can understand what that I taught you guys for today. And I wish you guys good luck. So don't forget to do your exercise. And thank you guys. That's all for today. See you. Bye.